A health alert tonight about baldness. Just how close are we to finding a cure?
Let's bring in our chief health editor, Dr. Partha Nandy. So is there a magical solution for hair loss?
Not quite yet, but this is a huge problem for so many of my patients. The medical term is a mouthful, androgenetic alopecia, but many of you have known it as a male or female pattern baldness. It's the most common type of hair loss, and more than 30 million women and 50 million men are affected by it. There's been years of research, but still no cure available today.
Are we close to a cure?
So absolutely. Scientists are getting closer to finding the cause, which could lead to new treatments. University of Texas researchers identified a protein that tells the cells in the skin to become hair. So when this protein was removed in mice, the hair stopped growing and the mice became bald. Another study, University of Edinburgh, found hair growth could be restored quickly by inhibiting enzymes called JAK that live in hair follicles. So some stuff being done that could really help.
What about stem cells?
So Heather, stem cells, Sanford Burnham Medical Research Institute developed a way to generate new hair with stem cells. Human, it's called pluripotent stem cells, again a mouthful, are turned into dermal papal cells, and when they implant into mice, new hair growth occurred. Now researchers using this technique in human is next.
All right, as always, we're interested in your prescriptions.
That's right, I've got them. So hair loss in men and women happen for different reasons, so the treatment depends on the cause. So first, if the hair loss is bothering you, or if you have sudden or patchy hair loss, see your doctor. Most hair loss is hereditary, but others are temporary or caused by an underlying condition. Secondly, before trying any hair loss treatment, please talk to your doctor first to define what the cause is. This could be different treatment options. Also, when washing, brushing, and styling your hair, be gentle and use a wide tooth comb to prevent pulling out hair. And lastly, current treatments include over-the-counter medications like minoxidil, finasteride. There's also hair transplants and low-level laser therapy. These only manage hair loss. They're not a permanent solution.
Well, is there help for those who have alopecia areata?
Another mouthful. So a small study found treating patients who had moderate to severe alopecia areata with the medication with a medication that I can't pronounce right now, and hair growth of 92%. Alopecia areata is an autoimmune disorder where you have clumps of hair suddenly fall off. So we'll have more on WXYZ.com for more details about the medication as well.
Yeah, but as you say, many, many people affected.
Absolutely.
Yeah. All right, doctor, thanks.
Well, thank you
You're welcome.
Much, Dr. Nandy. If you have a question or a health concern for the doctor, you can email him, Dr. Nandy at WXYZ.com, or send it on to Facebook or Twitter.